I do want to start us all the way sitting down on the mat today. So much like you would open yourself into a yoga practice, have a seat on the yoga mat. Cross-legged or back on the heels, close the eyes for a moment or turn the gaze low. Center yourself with a few breaths. Visualize your breath rising from your belly up into the ribs, up into the chest. Exhaling from the chest through the ribs, back down into the belly. That full, complete line of breath going throughout this class as much as possible. And take a nice, easy twist here as you open the eyes. Take both hands over towards the right side. Sit up taller through the spine and look to the side or back over the shoulder. Nice easy twist to the second side. And then come back to your middle, switch on over to all fours. Hands under the shoulders, knees underneath our hips. At first, just shift really side to side here in the hips, like I'm taking all of my weight over to one side, over to the other side, almost like I'm gonna fall to one side or the other. And then start to shift around in circles through the hips, coming forward towards the wrist and back towards the heels. Awakening our body and the movement this morning. Go in the opposite direction as well here. And then stay back in child's pose. Reach the arms out long in front. As you crawl back forward, set up on the forearms, forearm plank to get us heated up. Walk the feet back so knees are off of the floor. Anytime we're holding plank pose, be it on the forearms or on the hands, the knees could tap down or tap up to change the intensity of the posture. This is working all right. Keep the knees up here at the beginning. Try to look past the fingers rather than flat down. Squeeze the glutes, lengthen the tailbone, tone the abdomen, keep the hips pretty flat. We're simply holding here for 10 more seconds. And then set the knees back down, climb to the hands, so regular old all fours, and do cat and cow. As I look towards 2022, things I want to keep, things I want to evolve and change a little bit. Be trying out a little bit more of our traditional yoga movements in Triple B classes. So you'll see this come through a little bit more, I think. Downward facing dog. Go to downward facing dog. From downward facing dog, lift the right leg up into the air, three-legged dog. Pull the knee into the chest and hover forward. And we're going to do that a few more times. Inhale, Lift three-legged dog. Exhale, knee to chest, hover forward. Do it three more times, three-legged dog. And knee to chest, three-legged dog. Knee to chest, one more time. And knee to chest, hover and stay. Step the right foot all the way through into the low lunge. Take the right hand up to the sky and twisted lunge. Lower the hand down, step the foot all the way back to down dog. We've got one more side, lift the left leg high, three-legged dog. Knee to chest, hover forward. These work with the back knee down as well, more from an all fours position. We've got five, drawing in and out. That's two. Here's three, knee to chest, and up and back. Knee to chest, up and back. Knee to chest, three-legged dog. This time, step it all the way through into the lunge. Lift the left hand to the twist. Set the left hand down, step everything back to down dog, walk your hands back to your feet. So a nice deep bend in the knees should make it easier on the shoulders, upper body as you walk in. And then stay in a bent knee forward fold, that ragdoll position, feet wide, hold on to the elbows, let things hang heavy, sway a little bit from side to side. Let a few breaths out through the mouth. Slowly come all the way up to standing. As you do that, roll the shoulders up, back, and down a couple of times. And forward and down. Okay, everything gets a little bit of a wiggle and a shake. We're going to dive into the work holding on to weights. Picking up the 5-pound weights, just stand with your feet hip distance apart, feet about parallel to one another, little easy bend in the knees. This is just hammer curl, one arm at a time, right arm and left arm. You can stay right with me or take a different pace. What's important here is keep the chest lifted, shoulders right over the hips. Try to squeeze the elbows close into the side, not letting them fly forward as we take the hammer curl. We're going to do each exercise today to its fullest and then move on, meaning there's no sets. You won't see this come back. We're exhausting hammer curls right here. Working on longer single sets today. Here we are for 6 and 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. Set the weights all the way down. Moving into the legs with no weights at all, take the feet nice and wide. Turn the toes out a bit here. Bend the knees and pulse. Sumo squat, or sometimes called goddess squat. We're hanging down at the lower end of this. You could also sort of groove a little bit side to side or simply stay right into the middle. A couple of different things that you can do with the hands. Keep them right here or take into that goalpost goddess shape. It's up to you. Sometimes the goddess shape is quite helpful because it's easy to see if we're dipping down and looking at the ground. Try to stay straight upright. No pulse, just stay low here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Straighten the legs, turn the toes parallel to one another. Wide-legged forward fold, touch down to the ground. Lean over towards your right foot. And then walk both hands over towards the second foot. Come back into the center, hands to the waist, push down into the feet, come all the way upright, heel toe the feet in. Little shake. I'm gonna hold on to my lightest weights, the 3 pound here. Go back to some work in the upper body. Come to the front short side of the mat. Bend the knees, drop the weights right down in front of the knees, about shoulder distance apart. And we're going one arm at a time here again. It's a row with a tricep kickback in and down, one arm at a time. Row, tricep kickback, pull back in and down. Legs getting some attention since we're in that chair pose or a higher squat the whole time. These are one arm at a time, and so I've picked up the lighter set of weights that I have to use. Options would be to go two arms at the same time. Sometimes just carrying that same balanced weight can be a little more doable in the position. Or of course, using no weights at all. The repetition of the movement, doing the good calisthenic work that we need. We're still here one arm at a time with the row and the kickback. One more time, one side at a time, and then we are gonna add them together. So for the last four, you row together, kick back, in, down, row, kick back, in, down. Feeling this in my legs, yeah. Last one, pull in, kick back, in. Down, stand up. Keep holding on to those same weights. Kick out the legs a little bit. Take a breath in. Clear the space. And out. Going back down to the lower chain in the body. This time we're just racking to the shoulders. I'm gonna hold on to the lighter set. You can always change to something heavier or something lighter. Body weight only. Good old squats, down and up. You'll notice I'm not gonna get in a rush here. I'm also not going super slow. Almost like a constant walking pace, just down and up. Getting one set of higher reps today throughout. Keep the chest lifted even in the lower end of the squat. Do that nice scoop of the tailbone, push the hips forward each time you stand. If you notice breath getting really heavy, just drop the weights down by the side. Finish the reps out there. We've got six more. Here we are. Six, five, four, three, two, and one. Set the weights down for a moment. Come to the back to the top end of the mat if you'd left. Lift both arms up to the sky. This sort of clear the space is one sun salutation. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Step back to plank. Lower flat down to the belly. Feel the chest up for cobra. Go to downward facing dog. Hold here. From down dog, lower down to the knees so you're in all fours. A little bit of mobility work. Turn the fingers so they face out towards the sides. And just like we started with, just rock the body a little bit side to side. Keep the fingers, the hands as is, or take that one more 90 degree turn with the fingers facing back towards the knees. And that sway side to side becomes a little bit of a circular motion. Go easy on yourself. This one's pretty intense at all times. Circle in the opposite way as well. And then nice and slow, turn the hands all the way back around. Great, lift the right leg up and back. Imagine that three-legged dog that we were doing in the beginning, but this time opposite arm and leg, and hold. No reps here, just a longer hold. Option is both hands down or even onto the forearms with that right leg lifted. Now I do want left arm to come back down, keep the right leg as is, and add in little pulses, lift, lift, lift. Keep going, but bend the right knee and lift, lift, lift. Take knee into the chest, curl like cat pose. Take the cat pose out of it, think more longer spine, and now lift the knee out to the side and in. Fire hydrant. Out to the side and in. Try to keep the hips relatively square. They are gonna turn out a bit. The weight is gonna shift a bit. One side more than the other, but we're doing our best to center. Lift the right leg out to the side for three, and in for two, and in, and for one, and in. Sit back on the heels for a moment. Give your upper body a bit of a break. Roll through the shoulders, whatever feels. Let's go to the second side, get it done with. So here it's left leg up and back. Right arm out in front, and the first thing is hold and sustain. Look towards the right hand rather than down at the ground. Notice how the body needs to shift a little bit to continually hold balance. We've got this just a tiny bit longer. All right, set the right hand down, keep left leg as is, and little pulse. Again, if upper body's feeling a little taxed, give it a break. Come down onto the forearms. Bend the left knee and keep poking left toes straight up towards the sky. More of that scorpion tail. Now pull the knee into the chest, round the back like cat pose. You want to keep the knee in, but give more extension back into the spine. And we take it out to the fire hydrant, to the side and in. Not the best visual in the world, but it works like an animal lifting their leg right beside that fire hydrant. It's got to lift and get out of the way. You've got five more lifts here. Five and in. Four. Three. Two. And one. Again, sit back on your heels. Shake out the arms and upper body a little bit. And then stretch full to downward facing dog. Last set, using the weights, come down to your knees, and we're actually coming all the way down to our back. You pick your 3 or your 5 pound weights. I'm gonna go with my medium, my 5 pound set to lie down. Soles of the feet on the mat. We are simply holding weights straight up towards the sky. I sometimes call this dead bug. You can add the legs up as well. I think again, you can see that visual. Often with a very straight limbs here, dead bug turned over. You are holding. I'm doing this for stabilization in the arms and upper body. Feet are the bonus. They could also stay down if you'd rather. The second half of this one is bend your elbows about halfway. A little bit more resistance. If you're bending the elbows, bend the knees as well. Instead of having the knees close to the forearms or elbows, try to take them out over the line of the hips, and you'll get some good core action too. Again, we're stabilizing right here. Give yourself a count of 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Carefully rock yourself up to a seated position. I'm going to switch to my lighter set of weights. Plug them together. Elbows out to the side. And twist. Twist from side to side. Lots of different names for this. I like to call it the boxer twist. I don't like to hold a lot of weight. Be good to yourself. You could definitely do this unweighted. We want a nice full twist. Slow it down rather than speed it up. to get the full range and benefit. And high reps here, so we keep going. Feel free to drop the weight at any point to keep it safe and steady for you. Try to up the game here, lift the feet off of the ground and do. We're in this boxer twist just for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lie back down onto the mat. Weights handy on either side. Pull the knees into your chest. Rest and breathe here. That rest, oh so important in between the exercises. And then set the soles of the feet flat down onto the mat, if not already. Take the weights onto the front of the hips. Bridge pose, weighted. Push down through your feet, shoulders, back of the head, and lift the hips up. This is the top of the position. We're gonna go halfway down. And then all the way back up and all the way down. I call this one London Bridge. It's all the way up, halfway down, all the way up, all the way down. Let's go for it. Up, halfway, up, and down. Letting these big muscle groups fatigue today through high repetitions. I always find finding the position, definitely going on the slower side for the first few repetitions to get the good alignment set into the body. Doing weight, adding weight that is doable over a long set of repetitions. Really great way to tone the body while keeping us nice and healthy, not overdoing it. You're still in these London Bridge. All the way up, halfway down, all the way up, all the way down. Keep going. Remembering we can always drop the weight at any time. Body weight is a real thing. Plenty of good work there. All right, we're coming towards the end of this repetition. Two more full London Bridge. Last one. Weights totally out of your way. Pull the knees back into the chest. Give them a good squeeze and hug. Take the hands out to a T shape. Drop both knees over towards the right side in a supine twist. And the knees come across the center on over to the second side. And everything comes back to the middle. Carefully rock yourself up to a seated position and come all the way back up to standing. As you stand up, clear your space so weights are out of the way. We're done picking them up for this practice. I saved our triple B sun salutations here for the end of class rather than the beginning, as I normally do. So come stand at the back end of the mat, extend the arms down by your side, and gaze forward to the front end. Think of this as your HIIT interval at the end of class, staying with more of a yoga mindset and breath work though. Inhale, lift the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Walk out to plank position. Right knee in and back, left knee in and back for slow mountain climbers. There's eight here, four more, three, two, and one. Lower flat down to the mat, superhero, reach the arms forward. Lift and lower, there's four like this. Lift and lower. Arms can definitely be out to the side or back behind you to make that more doable in the shoulder. Using the knees, press back up to all fours. Step the right foot around the right hand. Step the left foot around the left hand. Stand all the way up and you're into your body weight squat. Hands right in front of the chest in prayer. Down and up eight times. So it's constant movement. We're more in a low impact zone. This is not the cardio, running, cycling. It's just smooth and steady. Hands down. Step back to downward facing dog. Twisted down dog. Take the right hand to the left leg. Set it down, take the left hand to the right leg. Set it down, walk the hands back to the feet. Inhale, rise up, lift the arms to the sky. Do it all over again. Exhale, fold. That deep bend in the knees really helps in terms of the weight transfer and where you're going as you walk the hands out to full plank. Slow mountain climber, right and left, eight times. Each knee counts. Flat down to the mat. Back extensions. Hands can go forward, to the side, or back. Do four here. Lift and lower. Lift. Lower, lift, lower. Come to all fours. Step to the front of the mat, right foot forward, left foot forward, hands to the knees to come up to standing and eight reps of your body weight squat. Feet as wide as the mat, keeping toes, knees straight ahead. That's not how your anatomy works. A little turnout in the feet and knees might be helpful. Don't overdo it though. Where am I at? I think I'm on 6, 7, 8. Hands to the mat, forward fold. Feet come back to down dog. Hold it for a breath. And then add the down dog twist if you're adding the twist. Right to the left, set it down. Left to the right, set it down. Walk the hands gently back to the feet. Stand, reach the arms to the sky. And just release arms down by your side. Taking in how you feel. The good work, the heat of the body. One more look at core strengthening, and then we are cooling down. So change again to sit down, lie down onto the mat. Oblique focus here, penguin or heel taps. Last ask. Lift your head and shoulders off of the mat. Reach your hands as if they're brushing towards your heels. And it's that side-to-side movement. Tap, tap, tap. If you can easily tap fingers to your heels, you can think about trying to reach towards the toes. Just a little glide, head and shoulders off the mat the whole time. Side to side. Count 20 more taps. It ends up going quick, I promise. I'm down to 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower head and shoulders. Knees to chest. Hug it in. Set the soles of the feet down, cross the right leg over the left thigh, point the knee out to the side, figure four shape. Nice easy stretch and cool down here. I say nice and easy to remind us to click into that more down-regulated system. You're not overly striving here, just kind of what feels nice. Pull the left foot off of the floor. Hug in tighter as feels right. Switch to your second side, left ankle over the right thigh, right knee. Point the knee out to the side, pull it in. With both legs down, give yourself a full body stretch, arms overhead, reach, reach, reach from fingertips down to the toes. And then change so the fingers are up towards the sky. Use that as a nice slow sit up. Lift the arms, lift the torso. Once you are sitting up, right knee comes in, right foot comes in, I should say, and over, hug tight, and twist. Look out over the right shoulder. Untwist, switch sides. Left foot in and over, sit tall to the thigh and look over the left shoulder.
So you untwist, both legs go out, give them a little bit of a pat, let yourself just sort of forward fold over the legs for a few breaths.
And then as you sit back up, find a final sit so the legs could stay out or cross underneath you. Just turn the palms down to be heavy along your thighs. One of the things in the new year that I want to bring into Triple B is having this moment of stillness. Letting ourselves really take in the good work that came through the movement of this practice. Couple more breaths. And for the last two breaths, turn the palms up. And a sign of allowing the goodness that you brought to yourself to leak out to others this day. Open to receive, open to give. Okay, thank you for Triple B today, taking the time to move your body.